أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سورة الفرقان. تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا، الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض ولم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك وخلق كل شيء فقدره تقديرا، واتخذوا من دونه آلهة لا يخلقون شيئا وهم يخلقون ولا يملكون لأنفسهم ضرا ولا نفعا ولا يملكون موتا ولا حياة ولا نشورا. وقال الذين كفروا إن هذا إلا إفك افتراه وأعانه عليه قوم آخرون، فقد جاءوا ظلما وزورا. وقالوا أساطير الأولين اكتتبها فهي تملى عليه بكرة وأصيلا، عليه بكرة وأصيلا. قل أنزله الذي يعلم السر في السماوات والأرض إنه كان غفورا رحيما. وقالوا ما لهذا الرسول يأكل الطعام ويمشي في الأسواق لولا أنزل إليه ملك فيكون معه نذيرا، أو يلقى إليه كنز أو تكون له جنة يأكل منها. وقال الظالمون إن تتبعون إلا رجلا مسحورا. انظر كيف ضربوا لك الأمثال فضلوا فلا يستطيعون سبيلا. تبارك الذي إن شاء جعل لك خيرا من ذلك جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ويجعل لك قصورا. بل كذبوا بالساعة وأعتدنا لمن كذب بالساعة سعيرا. إذا رأتهم من مكان بعيد سمعوا لها تغيظا وزفيرا. وإذا ألقوا منها مكانا ضيقا مقرنين دعوا هنالك ثبورا. لا تدعوا اليوم ثبورا واحدا وادعوا ثبورا كثيرا. قل أذلك خير أم جنة الخلد التي وعد المتقون، كانت لهم جزاء ومصيرا، فهم فيها ما يشاءون خالدين، كان على ربك وعدا مسؤولا. ويوم يحشرهم وما يعبدون من دون الله فيقول أأنتم أضللتم عبادي هؤلاء أم هم ضلوا السبيل. قالوا سبحانك ما كان ينبغي لنا أن نتخذ من دونك من أولياء ولكن متعتهم وآباءهم حتى نسوا الذكر وكانوا قوما بورا. فقد كذبوكم بما تقولون فما استطيعون صرفا ولا نصرا، ومن يظلم منكم نذقه عذابا كبيرا. وما أرسلنا قبلك من المرسلين إلا إنهم ليأكلون الطعام ويمشون في الأسواق، وجعلنا بعضكم لبعض فتنة أتصبرون، وكان ربك بصيرا. وقال الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا لولا أنزل علينا الملائكة أو نرى ربنا، لقد استكبروا في أنفسهم وعتوا عتوا كبيرا. يوم يرون الملائكة لا بشرى يومئذ للمجرمين ويقولون حجرا محجورا. وقدمنا إلى ما عملوا من عمل فجعلناه هباء منثورا. أصحاب الجنة يومئذ خير مستقرا وأحسن مقيلا. ويوم تشقق السماء بالغمام ونزل الملائكة تنزيلا. الملك يومئذ الحق للرحمن، وكان يوما على الكافرين عسيرا. ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه ويقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا، يا ويلتى ليتني لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا. لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني، وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. فقال الرسول يا رب إن قومي اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا. وكذلك جعلنا لكل نبي عدوا من المجرمين، وكفى بربك هاديا ونصيرا. وقال الذين كفروا لولا نزل عليه القرآن جملة واحدة، كذلك لنثبت به فؤادك ورتلناه ترتيلا. ولا يأتونك بمثل إلا جئناك بالحق وأحسن تفسيرا. الذين يحشرون على وجوههم إلى جهنم أولئك شر مكانا وأضل سبيلا. ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب وجعلنا معه أخاه هارون وزيرا. فقلنا اذهبا إلى القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا فدمرناهم تدميرا. وقوم نوح لما كذبوا الرسل فأغرقناهم وجعلناهم للناس آية وأعتدنا للظالمين عذابا أليما. وعادا وثمود وأصحاب الرس وقرونا بين ذلك كثيرا. وكلا ضربنا له الأمثال وكلا تبرنا تتبيرا. ولقد آتاه على القرية التي أمطرت مطر السوء أفلم يكونوا يرونها بل كانوا لا يرجون نشورا. وإذا رأوك إن يتخذونك إلا هزوا أهذا الذي بعث الله رسولا. إن كاد ليضلنا عن آلهتنا لولا أن صبرنا عليها. وسوف يعلمون حين يرون العذاب من أضل سبيلا. أرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هواه فأنت تكون عليه وكيلا. أم تحسب أن أكثرهم يسمعون أو يعقلون. إن هم إلا كالأنعام بل هم أضل سبيلا. ألم تر إلى ربك كيف من ظل ولو شاء لجعله ساكنا ثم جعلنا الشمس عليه ظليلا. ثم قبضناه إلينا قبضا يسيرا. وهو الذي جعل لكم الليل لباسا والنوم سباتا وجعل النهار نشورا. وهو الذي أرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته وأنزلنا من السماء ماء طهورا لنحيي به بلدة ميتا ونسقيه مما خلقنا أنعاما وأناسيا كثيرا. ولقد صرفناه بينهم ليذكروا فأبى أكثر الناس إلا كفورا. ولو شئنا لبعثنا في كل قرية نذيرا. فلا تطع الكافرين وجاهدهم به جهادا كبيرا. وهو الذي مرج البحرين هذا عذب فرات وهذا ملح أجاج وجعل بينهما برزخا وحجرا محجورا. وهو الذي خلق من الماء بشرا فجعلناه نسبا وصهرا. وكان ربك قديرا. ويعبدون من دون الله ما لا ينفعهم ولا يضرهم. وكان الكافر على ربه ظهيرا. وما أرسلناك إلا مبشرا ونذيرا. قل ما أسألكم عليه من أجر إلا من شاء أن يتخذ إلى ربه سبيلا. وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت وسبح بحمده وكفى به بذنوب عباده خبيرا. الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وما بينهما في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش الرحمن فاسأل به خبيرا. وإذا قيل لهم اسجدوا للرحمن قالوا وما الرحمن ونسجد لما تأمرنا وزادهم نفورا. تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا. وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا. وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا. وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما. والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما. والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما. إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما ومن تاب وعمل صالحا فإنه يتوب إلى الله متابا والذين لا يشهدون الزور وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما والذين إذا ذكروا بآيات ربهم لم يخروا عليها سما وعميانا والذين يقولون ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما أولئك يجزون الغرفة بما صبروا ويلقون فيها تحية وسلاما خالدين فيها حسنت مستقرا ومقاما قل ما يعبأ بكم ربي لولا دعاؤكم فقد كذبتم فسوف يكون لزاما.
صدق الله العظيم. This surah that I've just recited is Surah Furqan. Surah Furqan is it's in the second, it's in the latter half of the Quran in terms of not surah number, but in terms of the amount of Quran that comes before and after it. It ranks among my favorite surahs of all time. Not that that's something you're ever supposed to admit to, but you know, if you can have a favorite flavor of ice cream when there's no superiority and still admit ice cream is cool across the board, you can totally say the Quran is all wonderful, but I have a favorite passage, etc. The thing that I love about this surah is the tempo, the words are being said, and I've intentionally left the meaning visible so that any of you who are following along could easily see the meaning of what was being said rather than focusing on the Arabic lettering. I think the key things for me, if I was going to share a personal story, would be two things. First, the word Furqan is wonderful. Furqan comes from Faraq or Farq, which tends to mean division or breaking, to split between two things. The Furqan, or the criterion, would be that which is used to distinguish between right and wrong, the thing that breaks right from wrong separately, and is another word given to the Quran, as you can tell just from here. تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ Blessed is he who sent the Quran, the Furqan, on his abd, on his servant, that he may be to the world a warner. I think part of what I love about Surah Furqan is the praise of the Quran within it, and the blessings of the Quran that are told from within. There's one place where it says, no, it's not that. Where is it? Here. This is where we're talking about the people who are led away on the day of Qiyamah and the woe that they'll be in, and how they'll wish that they had not led the way they had, and instead, talking about the friends that they took, he led me away from the remembrance after he had come to me, and Satan to man is ever deserting, he will always leave man behind. And then, وَقَالُ الرَّسُولُ And the Prophet said, and the Prophet has said, يَا رَبْ O my Lord, إِنَّ قَوْمِي Truly my nation, اتَّقَذُ has taken, has seized, has, خُد means to take. They have taken it upon them. They have taken هذا القرآن, this Quran, مهجورا. مهجورا means something to which hijra has been done. And speaking to an Arab when I was trying to understand the classic sense, the core of this word, the word مهجورا should conjure up the image of an abandoned house. Something which is fallen into disrepair due to lack of attention paid to it. This speaks deeply to me. From the Quran, the idea that this message is something which people have not done tadabbur of and not paid due reverence to, but rather have taken as something that is valid to be forgotten and ignored. And I can tell you candidly that within my own life, there are times and places where I don't read the Quran enough, where I don't pay attention to it, where I don't let it be the guiding and the guidance and beacon I need, but instead turn to other things for that same solace when I have the Quran, which ought to be doing that for me. So this verse has always struck me as being very powerful. And the thing that came right after it, remember, Allah revealed Islam in the Quran not for one people in one place, but for all people in all times. And frequently when Allah talks about different prophets, He'll mention their enemies and you know, for the Ad and the Thamud people, for Salih, where did the obstacle for the messenger of Salih, where the obstacle for the messenger of Hud, etc. Well, I guess reverse that order. The very next verse, and I know this is not the standard interpretation, so bear with me. Wa and kavadika, in that nature, in that manner, ja'alna, we ja'alad, we made, li kulli nabi, to every prophet, li means to, li kulli, to every nabi, prophet, abu, an enemy, min, from, al-mujrimin, those who are mujrims, which I guess is correctly translated here as criminals. I can't be certain of the exact meaning of that word. I know it's a bad guy category. I don't know what mujrim means specifically as opposed to any other number of negative words. In this manner, we have made for every prophet an enemy from among those who are criminals. وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ هَادِيًا وَنَصِيرًا. And sufficient is your Lord as the Hadi, the guider, وَنَصِيرًا, and helper. I believe that this verse connects back to this verse. While what is probably specifically being referenced by min al-mujrimin here are the ones who we refer to here by those being led away, that oh no, وَيَوْمَ يَعُدُّ الظَّالُمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ, they'll bite his own hand and say, I wish I had taken, I يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا, would that I could have taken a path with the messenger rather than a path with someone else. يَا وَيْلَتَ لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا, I wish I had not taken such a friend, the friend that led him astray, he led me away from the members of God. So that is presumably the mujrim being referred to here. What I can't help but notice is the juxtaposition of these two verses, and what I'm thinking is, the enemy for our prophet isn't necessarily a man or a group of men, but is this, that my people have chosen to take the Quran as a thing to do, to treat as masjura. They have come up with other sources of religion. They have come up with other sources of morality. They have come up with other sources of guidance, solace, hidayah, whatever it is the Quran should be filling. When Allah's last messenger said, I leave behind you two things, my Quran and my Sunnah. Not my Ahlul Bayt, my Quran and my Sunnah. And whomever follows these will not be led astray. Well, you know, this is what I think is missing. This is the missing link. This is what has been left as an enemy to us, is our own neglect of the Quran and its teachings and its guidance in our lives. Down the road, there's another verse, and I'm trying to find it. If I'm not sure where I would find it, let me guess at what the English translation would be. That also means a lot to me. There it is, right here. أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَهُ هَوَاهُ أَفَأَنْتَ تَكُونُ عَلَيْهِ وَكِيلًا. Makes it a question. Ra'a means to see, so ru'ya would be a vision, and ra'ay would be past tense, and the at the ending makes it you. Ra'ayta, have you seen, because it's a question, man ittakhadha, who, ittakhadha, does khud, seizes, ilahuhu, his lord, hawahu, his desires. Have you seen the one who takes as his God his desires? أَفَأَنْتَ تَكُونُ عَلَيْهِ وَكِيلًا. Again, this same from before makes it a question. So here it would be فَأَنْتَ تَكُونُ عَلَيْهِ وَكِيلًا. So you, تَكُونُ, will be on him, over him, وَكِيلًا, a protector, وَكِيلًا. Would you then try and be his protector? It is a question to being most directly addressed to the prophet, or he who is trying to, well, if you look at the context, it's talking about the way people would ignore the prophet and ridicule him. Have you seen the one who takes his God, his desires as his Lord, would be the most direct translation, takes as his God his own desire? Would you then choose to be responsible? Would you be his responsibility? Can you be responsible for him? أَمْ تَحْسَبُ أَنَّ أَكْثَرُهُمْ يَسْمَعُونَ أَوْ يَعْقِلُونَ Or do you حَسِبَ, do you assess أَنَّ أَكْثَرُهُمْ, that verily most of them listen, يَسْمَع, أَوْ يَعْقِل, or reason, or think? إِنْهُمْ إِلَّا كَالْأَنْعَامِ Verily they are nothing more than cattle. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا Nay, they are even more astray in their way. They are even more misguided in their path. This speaks to my mind most vehemently of the nature of of mankind. You can't know for certain, but there's a fair bet that a lot of us tend to put our desires first. And that can be done subtly, because the degree to which the human mind justifies and makes excuses for what it does is pretty dramatic. Once you are in the state that you are taking your desires as that which dictates what is right and wrong, what ought to and not ought to be done, what you feel is right over what you are told is right by God, you are vulnerable. You are incredibly vulnerable. And I say that you're vulnerable specifically because, well, in God's own words, do you think that you're actually listening or reasoning when you're in that state? You might think you are the person, but from an outside perspective, it's fairly obvious you're not. And we don't have to think very hard to think of examples in our life where we've seen our friends or family being addicted to something, being in the moment so caught up and driven by their own passion or desire that they don't really have an objective view of just how risky, stupid, cost inefficient, dangerous, etc., what they're doing really is. That kind of misguidance comes from being led away by your own passions. Now, what is the solution to this? I'm not certain. I'm not a mufti. I'm not a scholar. I'm just myself. And that's the beauty of the Quran, is that while it, obviously to know what Allah means most likely, you might want to turn to he who has the best study of interpretation. At the same time, this book was meant for everyone. These words were meant for everyone. And we all can glean what we can from our lives from it, because God guides us by it. What I take away from this personally is, don't trust yourself as the assessment of whether or not you are or are not guilty of تَخَذَ إِلَهَهُ هَوَى, having seized your desires as your God. Tie yourself to someone outside of you who you trust to help you make that interpretation. For example, I know that there's a person in my life whom I trust immensely with that decision. There's a person whom in my life whom I would be happy, whom if they tell me, are you sure you're not just doing this because you want X, it will make me think twice and thrice about it. Because the reason of man is such that it can be used against him by that own intellect that tries and justifies for you what you do. And I'd go on. I mean, honestly, to any of you who haven't read this surah and understood what you were reading or heard it read, this last passage is beyond powerful, and I can't do it justice in this blurb. So I'm going to cut this vid here. But thank you for listening. I hope this was at least of some use to you. Go out and read your Quran, guys. It's sitting on your shelf. And do not takhada it as mahjura, because that is a danger. And Allah knows best. Fi amanillah. Assalamu alaikum. Allah, take care.